For those of you watching the band for the very first time, when we say ala la la la, normally people answer uro ro ro ro. To come from?
Ala la la la. Ala la 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 la.
Yes, this is what we do at the New African Shrine. Yes, we are here to promote the album. Well, no, talk about it. So for you to listen to the album, I'm sure most of you have people who heard it too. Yeah. Apparently they wanted to ask me a few questions before we started.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
All right, yeah.
You're shining more than myself.
Just trying to reflect more. As I cannot play an instrument, let me just try some.
Please.
Thank you so much. All right. Let me just let you know that this is...
I hope you don't mind if I sit down small, eh?
Sir, please go ahead.
It's not like I'm getting lazy, but I think it's like more of like a gathering. So let's acquaint ourselves with ourselves.
I like our starting of this note. Because in my mind, you're one of my favorite uncles.
Okay.
We have regular conversations.
Most people think I'm their daddy's uncle. I'm looking for their mommies, so we can't get their uncle. La, 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 la.
Okay, so it is about the new album. And I know a lot of people are very excited. So, I mean, you have a music career that has spanned decades. You have worked with...
Four now.
Four decades.
Four decades.
For some of the stuff on his name.
Sorry, just before we go, what's that noise at the back? Must we be so troublesome? Thank you.
Okay, let's go for
High Service International. You don't bring time for me, as fine, because you are sure that you are making time for me. Don't worry. Don't bring time for me, as fine.
What a lot of people would love to know is, with such an extensive musical history and background, what new influences are there in this album that's coming out? Would you say it has perhaps more of a world sound? I'm just curious, what new experience is there in One People, One World?
To be honest with you all, I have not listened to music for about, since 2000. I mean, going out of my way. Of course, if I go to the supermarket or in the cinema or at a party or TV, I'm forced to listen to music, but I never go out of my way these days. At the beginning, it was more my father, of course, then. He influenced them, of course, Michael Jackson, James Brown, name them, Bob Marley. But then my father got me involved in jazz, and it was really jazz fanatic I was. And then I got to a stage, I read Miles Davis' book, who says that he wanted to be original, he wanted to find something new, and he stopped listening to music. So that was my first, wow, this is high-level thinking of a composer. So I said, let me try it. And I said to see that, I said to hear sounds better, clearer, and I could identify my music more from my personality, my thinking, and directly from me, without influences from too much from my father or jazz or... So my music these days really is from life, most especially being a father. I love my kids so much. So I think they are so troublesome that... No, really, honestly. When I'm on tour, my children are like, they're like terrorists, man. Really troublesome, you know. My dad playing bass today. When he was 6, 7, 8, they turned my sitting room. I have a big football field. They refused to play football outside. It was a sitting room. They started to play. You know this, monkey post? That's in my sitting room, so I could not have furniture because of them. I could not have a TV for like 5, 6 years. And then my wall was decorated with football patches. I mean, really quite nice design, but I mean, wasn't what I really wanted. Now, these ones are like, I have 6 like Mandy, and they give me so much pleasure and joy. Like when I'm away for like a month, I miss that trouble. So I said to understand that trouble was really love, you know? Love. When children say, I love you, there's nothing beats it. I mean, your girlfriend can tell you, I love you, and can say, are you sure? But why do you love me? When your child says, I love you, don't ask, why do you love me? You know, it's really directly godly. And so, I think most of my inspiration really comes from that source. And then life, meeting people, traveling, seeing the world the way I feel. I think we need to talk more about peace and things like this. So this really, when you watch TV, it's so, Syria, Afghanistan, Maiduguri, these things are really painful. So this again influences me. So really basically is my children and life, friends and blah, blah, blah. I talk too much.
No, just a perfect amount. And that actually tied in very nicely with what my second question was going to be, which is in the midst of so much turmoil that we experience, especially here at home, and we see it every day in the newspapers, we have to talk about it on radio. And your music is akin to an education of humanity, right? Before you came in, I did say that you are a teacher, really, through your medium. But how do you manage to stay positive through all of that, especially as so many young people have been taught apathy? We just feel, what's the point? I don't know if you know what to do.
I think we have to remain optimistic. If you listen to the album No Place for My Dream, sounds very pessimistic, but very truthful. I believe there has to be good, there has to be balance, equilibrium. There has to be balance in this life. Why the Creator made it so puzzles me. But when we look at life, you go into the sea, so much violence in the sea, the way fish eat themselves and everybody. I mean, you go to the forest, everybody's killing everybody. When we want to eat, we kill everything. Even when you say you're a vegetarian, you are still killing the plants. And they say the frequency of the plant is so high that when you even pluck the plant like this, the thing is screaming, but it's so high-pitched that we are too deaf to hear. So then I'm wondering, why did God make everything so violent? Then maybe our perspective of life is kind of wrong, or we are human, and we have to realize we are human beings, and we cannot, some things are just beyond us, and maybe the Creator doesn't want us to know for some reason. Because if we did know, then maybe we can say, what if I start talking to him like, you know, you might even take a gun and say, hey, motherfucker, I'm speaking my language. You know, so, and then, but then, with so much negativity in this world, there has to be positiveness, and some of us have to never forget there is true love, there is light at the end of the tunnel, and we always have to struggle forever. Probably, maybe this is the way life should be. And if we just sit back, then why be alive? Why have children? Why do I have children? And look at my son. He's so lovable standing there next to me. I'm sure many of you heard about my basis absconding. I know this one will not abscond. And if he did, I will come after you all. So in my band, even the band leader Okoyeni was telling me the other day, because of money, everybody is now, it's a new generation, and as we are getting older, we see new energy, and everybody around the band is supposed to like change their orientation more positively, more youthful, more, there's so much love going on in the band now, and you know, it's so nice.
Final questions. Everyone wants to hear the album, so I'm going to be done here. And I love that you mentioned your family so often. It's about legacy. And looking at that, what do you hope for this album to inspire in people? Do you think it will inspire maybe creative thinkers? I mean, just sort of passing knowledge on and passing a legacy, or not just to your family, but to the wider family, like, you know, who you are.
I think it will. The title of the album, One People, One World, we do have to understand that we are all one people. And when you go back into history, we all come from one source. And then we have to understand we are one planet. And whether we like it or not, we have to make it work. So when things are going on in Syria or Afghanistan, and they say America was throwing like 6,000 bombs a day, the way I look at it is like, let me take, for instance, my head or your head. Imagine me giving you a knock, one knock a day. And that's like the feel of all those bombs being thrown on Mother Earth. And if we think it's not going to affect us one day, it will. So when you're talking about climate change, these things are real. And we have to all come together, talk more about love, stop wars, stop making bombs and guns, and build a more humane society and things. I hope this album will give people that confidence not to lose hope. Especially the young, I always focus on the younger generation because I'm 56. I know I've crossed the border. So you know when you reach 50, anything can happen in your life. But don't worry, I'm not getting younger. Fine then. I'm old. And someone say, you're getting old. Wouldn't it be strange if I was getting younger? And you'd be wondering that, he's going to change your key. I really love, another thing about me people don't understand is I love getting older. I talk to my musicians and everybody close to me, the day I die, I want to die with a smile. These are things I put in the forefront of my life. I don't shy away from death. I've seen it so many times in my life, and the more I think we run away from these things, the more we get, we misrule our lives. We make many mistakes. The more you because death is inevitable, it's going to come sooner or later. And the more you embrace it, probably then you start to appreciate these things I've been talking about. Mother Earth, your friends, your family, and your close ones. Then you know when to tell someone, hey, I love you, I miss you. You know when to make that call and things. Because then you know that anytime, sooner or later, you're going to get out of here. So this is the way I try to live my life.
Thank you very much, sir. It's a circle of life. On that note, these are my questions. Let's get ready to enjoy one people, one world.